Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. Well, I guess a lot of you guys have been praying for me to give you a word from the Lord, because I was just praying and the Lord is telling me to give some more words. I've given, I think, about 40. I did two videos. This will be the third one. And I don't know if I'll get through this list, but if I get through this list, I'll tell you. And then, if there's lots of people sent me their name, I can't keep track. If I don't give your name, then can you email me? There's lots of people commenting on the video asking for a word. I would prefer, well, never mind. You can just comment on the video. Maybe that's easier. I need to go back. If I don't give you a word before this time or next time, then you gotta have to keep asking me, because so many names, brothers and sisters. Sometimes I check my messages and I'm traveling and I can't write it down. Anyway, let's pray right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, we thank you for your Holy Spirit. We thank you for your wisdom. We thank you for the gifts of the Spirit. Father, in Jesus' name, Lord, amen. And I just want to tell you guys about a few of the people I've given a word to have not contacted me. About 90% of the people I gave a word to did contact me and said that it was from the Lord. Two people contacted me and they said they didn't understand what it meant. One of them was for their relative, which I said in the video, was for one of their children probably, which after praying over it again and clarifying, yes, it was for their child, their adult child. The other person, the word I gave was that the Lord's going to open your eyes to something, and they're asking me what it is. Well, of course, they don't know what I'm talking about. Well, of course, because the Lord's going to open their eyes to it. All right. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I'm praying for Sister Amy. I ask all of you guys who are watching this to pray in agreement with me, because God is outside time, and even though you watch this tomorrow, your prayer will still be counted with me today. We pray for Sister Amy right now in Jesus' name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Lord God, we give you the praise, we give you the honor, we give you all of the praise, Lord God. Hallelujah. 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 And the Lord is just telling me, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. The kingdom of the Lord will stand. No weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises against you, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me. And God's kingdom will stand in Jesus' name. And the Lord is saying that your, Sister Amy, your kingdom will stand. So in this way, of course, you know, I always have to explain it, because there's always people that, most people are thinking carnal-minded. That's why they can't hear from the Lord. All of you guys can hear from the Lord. Even though God doesn't give everyone the gift of wisdom, a word of wisdom, or the gift of getting words of knowledge, or you know, a prophecy. There's three different ones. What I'm giving is a word of wisdom and a word of knowledge sometimes, and then sometimes a prophecy. That's a different teaching. I've done teachings on that. But the problem with most people, you're carnal-minded. And so when the Lord would give me something, when Jesus spoke to people, he spoke usually in a parable. And then his disciples said, why do you keep speaking in parables? And because Jesus said, it's been given unto you to understand, but not to the world. So that's why Jesus kept saying, who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church. So most of you who are asking for a word, number one, the Lord can speak to any of you in your spirit, man, by his Spirit. But number two, you don't have ears to hear. So that's why the Lord will speak it in a parable, because it's for the understanding of the person who the word is for. God speaks in a mystery, and it has a specific meaning to a specific person. That's how God operates, and you have to have an ear to hear. So what I just said was for Sister Amy. All right, let's pray right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. I just pray for Brother David in Jesus' name, Lord. And all of you guys come in agreement with me. Let's pray for Brother David. Let's lift him up right now in the name of Jesus. And the Lord is having me to tell you, God is exalted and Satan is defeated and Jesus Christ is Lord. That's the word for you, Brother David. I just did Amy. Okay. I got my list all messed up here. Now, I already given lots of several different words to this one sister from Statesville, North Carolina. Given her several words through messages. So, if the Lord gives me another message, I'll send it to you. privately, because the Lord is speaking to me to build on what the messages I've already given you about the salvation of your family. The Lord's going to, he who has begun a good work in you will see it through until the end. Sister there in Statesville, North Carolina, and as we already gave you a word from the Lord, that all your household will be saved, and so God will do it. It'll be done. Has God not said it? Will he not also do it? God is not a man that he should lie. Now I got one here, J. Lee, L-E-E. So I don't know. I think that's a J. Lee. So I don't know if that's just a man or a woman, or the first initial J. Father, right now, let's come in agreement, brothers and sisters. Let's pray for J. Lee. Hallelujah. And the Lord is just speaking for you. It's not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. You know, thank the Lord. The Lord told me to start doing this, and he would make it easier and faster as I went along. So the Lord is speaking to me quicker as we go along. Some of you guys have been praying for me to do this video, and it's what God has compelled me and anointed me to do it. So I'm doing it. All right. Carola, Sister Carola. Father, right now we pray for Sister Carola in the name of Jesus, Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We lift your name up, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. We lift your name up in this place. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. And the Lord is telling me to tell you that. Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw him into me. So, Sister Carola, Jesus talking in John chapter 3, he said, just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so shall the Son of Man be lifted up. And he was talking about being crucified. And he said, if I be lifted up, I will draw men to me. So we can say also for ourselves, we say, you know, we need to lift the Lord up. So when we exalt the name of Jesus, when we lift up his name, then God will draw men unto himself through the blood and the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Sister Carola, that's for you. Sister Lucy, right now in the name of Jesus, Father, we give you the praise and the glory as I pray for Sister Lucy. Lord, we honor, we praise you, we exalt your holy name in the name of Jesus. You are a righteous, holy God. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Father, we bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you, Lord, for that you are the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just hear from the Lord is joy. 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 That joy to the world. The song I keep hearing is joy to the Lord, to the world. The Lord has come. Let earth receive her king. That's the, what I'm hearing in my spirit for you, Sister Lucy. So the joy of the Lord, the kingdom of the Lord coming in your family, in your life, in your fellowship brings joy. The joy of the Lord is your strength. I want to come back to you, Sister Lucy, again. I want to come back to you. I'm circling your name because I feel the Lord wants me to tell you more. Let me just pray about it here. Sister Wendy of Deer Valley, Wendy. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we give you all the praise, all the glory, all the honor is yours, Lord God. For you are a righteous and a holy God. The Lord's telling me to tell you, Sister Wendy, draw near to me, and I'll draw close to you. From Jeremiah, call upon me, and I will answer and show you great and mighty things that you know not. Sister Wendy of Deer Valley, draw close to me, and I'll draw close to you. Brandon, excuse me, let's pray right now for Brandon in the name of Jesus. Father, we give you all the praise, all the glory. Lord, we honor you, we praise you, Lord. The Lord is telling me to tell you, Brandon, just like he told Joshua, meditate on my word day and night, and let my word not depart from your eyes, from before your eyes. Meditate in the Lord's word day and night. It's from Joshua chapter 1. That's the word of the Lord for you, Brandon. Sophia, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, we pray for Sister Sophia. The Lord is telling me to tell you, let the weak say I am strong, Sister Sophia. I think the Lord is speaking to me quickly as I even speak your name. Lots of people's names. Sophia, let the weak say I am strong. Next is there's a Joshua right here. Here's a Joshua. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Brother Joshua. Lord, we lift him up to you right now in the name of Jesus. And the victory belongs to the Lord, Brother Joshua. You know, the Lord is just speaking to me. You know, the theme of the book of Joshua is victory. And the Lord is telling me to tell you that victory belongs to the Lord. I will say of the Lord, He is my shield and my strength, my God in whom I will trust. That's the word of the Lord for you. You need to trust in the Lord. He's your victory, not yourself. Obviously, for those who are spiritually minded, and the Lord talks in a way that exhorts us, but basically, this is a teaching moment for everyone, like I did on the other videos. The Lord is saying you're trying to do it in your own strength. But He's saying He is your victory. He is your strength. See what I mean? When the Lord speaks a word, He doesn't condemn. You see, but He condemns, you know, the people who are not saved. He condemns, you know, those who die without Christ. But, and He condemns sin. But when the Lord is dealing with His people and those who will become His people, He can, when the Lord speaks something, even though it's saying something that you need to change, it's always in love. It's always an exhortation. That's how you know it's the Lord. It's not in the spirit of condemnation. The devil is the one who condemns. And I want to say this. There are some people on YouTube, when you watch their videos, and they're condemning and condescending to people, God's people, Christians, then you know that it's not in the spirit of love or the spirit of Christ, but in the spirit of condemnation, which comes from the enemy. Okay. So, the Lord is your victory, Brother Joshua. Not in your own self, but in the Lord. As the word that I gave you, as I mentioned, is the Lord. This is my addition to it, where I'm saying that don't do it in your own strength. Okay, Alicia, A-L-I-C-I-A-N, Alician. Forgive me if I'm pronouncing it wrong. Hey, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for this sister right now. Alicia, Father, we just praise Your holy name, Lord God. You are worthy of all praise and glory. Hallelujah, Lord. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah, Lord. You are the Messiah. And yes, that's what the Lord wants me to tell you, Sister Alicia. Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God. He is the Messiah. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the Son of God. The Lord is telling me this boldness. The Lord is telling me, and that's what, you know, what I was just saying. Peter said that because he was bold. And that's what the Lord wants you to do, or He's giving you the spirit of boldness, or He wants you to be bold and proclaim, who is Jesus? He's the Christ, the Son of the living God. He's the Messiah. He's the Lord and Savior. He is the Messiah, Jesus. God wants you, or He's giving you the spirit of boldness. That's the word I hear from the Lord for you, Sister Alicia. Alicia, I'm sorry if I know I'm not pronouncing it right. Boldness. Sherry, Sister Sherry, let's pray for her right now. Sister Sherry, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we declare victory, victory, victory right now. Victory in Jesus' name. Victory over death, hell, and the grave. The Lord says He's giving you victory over death, Sherry. He's giving you victory over death, hell, and the grave. All right. I want to keep moving, brothers and sisters. I'm sorry, but I want to keep moving and get everybody in there. That's the word for you, Sister Sherry. Anna. Anna, right now in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. The Lord is telling me to tell you also, let the weak say I am strong. Let the weak say I am strong. That's the second person. The Lord gave me the same word. Let the weak say I am strong, Anna. Holly, Sister Holly. We thank You, Lord, for our Sister Holly. We thank You for her exhortation work, her dreams. And most of these people, I don't match their name with their YouTube name and Facebook and all that. But Sister Holly, I've been saying this on every video. If it's somebody I know, I say that I know them. And I know Sister Holly from Facebook and her dreams, that some of her dreams she shared with me from the Lord. And let's pray for Sister Holly right now. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we thank You for Sister Holly, Lord. We ask You to continue to give her dreams and visions and wisdom, Lord God. And let her have the ability to keep sharing them, Lord God, in deep understanding. Right now, Lord, I just declare Your blessings upon her. Health, wealth, wisdom, peace, joy, and love. And I just declare the Lord is showing me like a x-ray of your, I just want to say it, your pelvic area, but x-ray inside, like your backbone and all that. I can see it, your pelvic area. Let's just pray for that right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. And Lord, we just declare that the Lord sees these things. He knows about these things, whatever they are. Sister Holly, I have no idea. And the Lord is just showing me that, like an x-ray of your abdominal region. And I just speak right now, victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I speak that there's a victory In the name of Jesus, and the battle is the Lord's always, in Jesus' name, Lord. We just pray for Sister Holly, Lord, for her victory over all things, Lord God, and be an overcomer in Christ, Lord. We declare that she is an overcomer in the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We honor you. I'm going to circle your name too, Sister Holly. The Lord will bring me back when I finish this. Sister Lucy and Sister Holly. Brother Mark, in the name of Jesus, Father, we give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. For Brother Mark, we come in agreement, Lord, that you would speak a holy wisdom to this brother. Lord God, we honor you, we praise you, we worship you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Salvation belongs to the Lord. Brother Mark, in other words, translation, you can't save anybody, but the Lord can. Only the Lord can save. All you can do is pray, sow seeds, you know, evangelize people, pray for them and get out of the way and don't, you know, overdo it. And let the Lord is the one who can save people. Brother Michael, right now in the name of Jesus, Father, we pray for Brother Michael in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the Lord has shown me a sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. And the Lord has shown me you with that sword of the Spirit, the Word of God, Brother Michael, in Jesus' name. Now, Brother Stanley, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Brother Stanley. Father, we honor you. We praise you right now for Brother Stanley, Lord God. And the Lord is telling me that to tell you the name of God the Father in Daniel chapter 7 and from the book of Enoch, but it's in Daniel chapter 7 in their canonized Bible. It's the Ancient of Days. And God says that he has showed you and is showing you the Ancient of Days, which is the Father. The Father is the Ancient of Days. All right. Kayla. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Kayla. We speak mysteries. The Lord has just given me that word about the behold that he speaks mysteries. And the Lord will speak mysteries to you. Now, mysteries is like secrets of his kingdom. Just as Paul said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall be changed. In the moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, we'll be changed. You know that it's talking about the rapture. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50, 51, 52, along in there. You can read that text. The Lord wants you to look at that text. That's what he wants to talk to you about. The mysteries of the translation of the body, changing from this corrupted body to an incorruptible body, taking off this earthen vessel and putting on an incorruptible heavenly body as the Lord had after his resurrection. Let's see. Zimmerman. Seems like I thought I read some of these names. I can't remember. I'm almost convinced I've said some of these names. Well, Zimmerman, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Father, we praise you in the name of Jesus. Right now I declare victory, victory, victory for Zimmerman. Zimmerman in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The Lord is speaking to me about self-righteousness. Self-righteousness. Now, Zimmerman, I don't know you or know anything about you. I don't know if this is about you or someone you're dealing with, but to be self-righteous is someone who's trying to keep the law. Now, we don't have righteousness in ourselves, but our righteousness comes from Jesus Christ. So, you know, very rarely do you give something that's like, you know, maybe it's for you or for somebody you're dealing with. We are not called to follow the law of Moses. And that's what the Lord means by self-righteous. That's the word I got for you or for someone around you that you're dealing with or yourself or around you. We don't be self-righteous. Where our righteousness comes from by faith, by grace, or we saved through faith, not of our own, but a gift of God. Not by works. That's self-righteousness. Least anyone should boast. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. Eyes. Somebody called themselves eyes. I thought I mentioned this before, but I'm not sure. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, hallelujah. The Lord has just shown me something about the blood. About the blood. Hallelujah. About the blood. Right now, I plead the blood of Jesus over eyes. Right now, the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. No weapon that's formed against you shall prosper. In Jesus' name, right now, I declare victory for eyes by the blood of Jesus right now. That it's through the blood. The Lord is just saying to me that you're walking through the valley filled with blood. I don't know what that means, but God is with you, and God will give you the victory in Jesus' name. It's the blood of Jesus that will deliver you and protect you and give you safety in the blood of Jesus. Kayanda. K-Y-O-N-D-A. Kayanda. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, we speak your grace, your mercy, your love, your kindness in Jesus' name. I keep hearing the blood again. I think this is two different people, but Kayanda, I also hear about the blood. I plead the blood of Jesus over Kayanda in Jesus' name. Father, I declare victory, victory, victory right now in Jesus' name for Kayanda. Lord, I speak that, Lord, right now. Bless your name, Lord. Grace. Hear the word grace for you. Kayanda, grace. Grace. By grace are you saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God. At least anyone should boast. Right now, I pray for Brooke. Right now, Father, I give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for Sister Brooke. Lord is just telling me just to break forth with shouts of joy, Sister Brooke. Break forth with shouts of joy. Father, we just honor you and we praise you. Hallelujah. And I declare that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Sister Brooke, the kingdom of God has come near you, Sister Brooke. So break forth with shouts of joy, for the kingdom of heaven has come near you. And this is S-A-M-M-I-E, Sammy. Father, right now I pray for Sammy in Jesus' name. The Lord is just speaking to me something for you, Sammy, which is really odd. It's the story of the night before Christmas. It was the night before Christmas. That's what the Lord is speaking to me, for me to speak to you. So I don't know what that means. Something happened to you or going on in that time frame, December 24th. I don't know what it means exactly. But let's pray, continue to pray for Sammy right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise and the glory and the honor right now. This is what the Lord, okay, so the Lord just gave me the Bible verse about how Joseph dealt with Mary, that he wanted to put her away in the story, the Christmas story, because the Lord is just speaking to me the story about, Jesus, or Joseph wanting to put Mary away privately and all of this. That's the Lord speaking to me. So the night before Christmas, you're talking about the birth of Christ. So the Lord is speaking to me about the story, about the nativity story, and how it went about on this wise. There's a Bible verse that says it was handled on this wise, or went on this wise. It's a King James word. It's from that same text. This is one way we know that God is speaking to us, because the Lord gave me that secular word, was the night before Christmas, and then he gave me a Bible verse after a moment as I sat here, reference to the nativity story. To confirm to me, because I wasn't sure what the Lord is saying. There's something to do with, I don't know your personal situation, what's going on with you, about a baby or anything like that. If that's what the Lord's referring to, or something to do with actually the virgin birth of Christ, I don't know. But you know. So we're praying for you in Jesus' name for your victory. I ask all you guys who are watching this, we're going to pray for all the people we gave a word for, and that the Lord will bless them, and they will hear from the Lord, and it will be a blessing to them and help them in their walk with the Lord. That's what this is all about, to help people to move more into the will of God in their lives. Sister Linda, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we give you the praise, we give you the glory, we give you the honor. And the Lord is speaking to me, for the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. That's the word of the Lord for you. Like that song, but it's from the Bible. It's a Bible verse. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever, Sister Linda. The Lord doesn't stop loving people. His love endures forever and he's good all the time. God is good, right? Karen, Sister Karen. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Karen. Hallelujah. Lord God, we give you the praise and the glory. And the Lord is just speaking to me about before the flood, or in the Garden of Eden, before the beginning, it says that a mist came out of the ground. And so the Lord is just speaking to me about that text from the Bible, Sister Karen, about how before the fall and in the Garden of Eden, the garden was watered by a mist that came out of the ground. I have no idea what that means, but that's what the Lord gave me for you. I need to go back. I'm going to circle your name too, because I'm not sure about that. Let's pray for Sue. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Sister Sue. And Lord, speak to me the word release. Release, release, release. Just the word release. I don't want to add to that unless the Lord tells me. Father, we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. So the word for the Lord for you, Sue, is release. Johnny, we pray for Brother Johnny right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for Brother Johnny right now in Jesus' name. And Lord is telling me the word for you is relax. Now I'm getting, this is a kind of a pattern here. I just got two in a row. I got release for Sue, relax for Johnny. One word from the Lord, relax in Jesus' name. Sister Mary, let's pray for her right now. Sister Mary, we pray for you right now in the name of Jesus. The love of the Lord is sweet and marvelous. That's the word for you. The love of the Lord is sweet and marvelous. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, we pray for Sister Steph. Steph, right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise. Sister Steph, hallelujah. The Lord is just speaking to me, I guess. I just keep hearing the word like flake, like for snowflake. The word, that's what I hear, but I don't know what it means either, Sister Steph. I'm going to circle your name too. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we give you the praise. Lord, I pray for Sister Robin. Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Lord, you know all things. You know all things, Lord. Hallelujah. And the Lord is just saying he's an all-knowing God. He knows all things. He's an all-seeing God and all-knowing God. God knows all things. That's for Sister Robin. God knows all things. He's an all-knowing God. There's nothing that he does not know. Rick L. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, you know, I gave a word. You know the word I gave before? Now I see the last name with us. It's Allison. Before, when I was saying it wrong, when I was saying Alicion, it's Allison because of my bad handwriting. When I mentioned it before, Allison, sister from Scotland. That's you. I even put your last name on here, which I will not say. Allison from Scotland, that word I gave about Alicion, whatever I was saying. That was you, sister. I misspelled your name. Now, I know this sister some too, but I didn't know it till just now. I see that her last name is over in the other column. I've got these other columns, and her last name is over there. Sister Allison. I might even put a note on there. Sister from Scotland. Rick L. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we give you the praise. The Lord is a light unto the Gentiles. And the Lord is calling you to be a light unto the Gentiles. In other words, I believe the Lord is saying you need to preach. Rick L., the Lord wants you to be a light unto the Gentiles also, like he was. Be a light. Andrea. Father, right now we pray for Andrea. Father, I give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Father, let your will be done. Hallelujah. We pray for Andrea right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Andrea, right now I just want to tell you that what I see is the Lord seated on his throne for you. I don't know what that means, but it means something for you. I see the Lord is seated on his throne. I see him seated on his throne, and I see his left arm. Left arm. I see his left arm. I've forgotten. I see right arm is judgment. Right arm is the strength of the Lord. I see the left arm of the Lord seated on his throne. I can't remember all these things all the time, but there's a meaning to that. You can look it up. God bless you guys. That's all the list that I have. There's lots of people that ask me at the bottom of these videos that I didn't write down. And there's lots of people that's been emailing me. I will say, if you watch this and you still want a word, please re-message me, either by email, and I need to make a new list. I'll work on it. And so I guess I've did maybe 75 names so far. By the grace of God, God bless in Jesus' name.